First carry for Raheem Mostert. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. They hand it off to Mostert.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Someone's looking fresh, and this O-line is definitely licking their chops. Everyone likes to run block. If you're an offensive lineman, nice early burst, nice gain, too.
Second down, Mostert, and he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
It did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you gotta like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game, and guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
First down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so second and 2.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
On first down, they go with Mostert again. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
On the handoff, this is Mostert. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Now third down is looming, a pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there. On play action, now Garoppolo. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off near the 34. And the Seahawks are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at the 34. Played collegiately here in the Golden State, Rashad Penny. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Eight yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Wilson leaves this one with Penny. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. There's Wilson. And the Niners get there and bring him down. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. That time on the punt, and the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Now, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
We're scoreless after one. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Garoppolo now, first down throw. He's got a man, it's his fullback. And he's got some space here. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. The fullback comes through with a big play there. Not really any offense for them to speak of here in this first half. Maybe that's what they needed, that big play.
Yeah, it seems that maybe everything changes right there. They've been a little slow out of the gate. We've seen that. But that one big play, that could spark a big burst right here.
Garoppolo going to give to Mostert. Oh, he gets free left side. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Raheem Mostert, 22 yards. As his guys are on the board first here tonight. Gold with the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
A nice little screen. They get six on first down. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. They'll try the right side here with Penny.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. They set up the screen to Penny. And some room to maneuver. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10, down at the 33. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of four. And they'll work from the 29 on second and six. Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Play action. Now Wilson. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10. Try and run for it with Penny.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Rashad Penny. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And the Seahawks are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll try to run with Carson. And he's across the chalk, into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. Chris Carson, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Jason Myers now for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to get this drive underway. And with a little under a minute to play, they may be looking to pick up some yardage here, maybe try and come up with a field goal to seize the lead before intermission. On first down, Garoppolo. And they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. So this time they'll just keep this on the ground. And not much happening there as he'll get it back to the line of scrimmage and no more. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Now Garoppolo looks to throw, rolling to his left. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now San Francisco going to call their 2nd timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. It's Garoppolo. They'll roll him out right. This one caught by Kittle. And they will get the first down here as they move into field goal range as well inside the 25. Now the Niners going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Take the lead here now at 10-7. That looked a little bit off. You expect more leg out of him, but he did get it to go.
Well, you and I both know sometimes, depending on the angle, they may take a little bit off of the kick in order to make sure that they line it up properly and bring it home through the posts.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. He lets it fly for Lockett. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far.
The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. He was solid on the field goal, but not as solid on the kickoff there, and that'll put him at the 40-yard line to start this drive. Wilson of the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at the 41-yard line. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of gain. Now it's Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 38. They'll run this with Homer. And he's going to get this inside the 30. So they go pass, now they go run, and two plays resulting in really nice pickups.
Certainly sounds like a 50-50 deal, doesn't it? Sounds like great balance. Well, you know what all those coaches have told us over the years, Brandon, that balance is? It means doing what you want to when you want to. That play calling is working very well for them right now.
On first down. Now they go screen. It's complete. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4.
And that's all about recognition right there because he's got to go from pass rush mode to pursuit mode, what defensive line coaches like to call retracing. And he's able to retreat and make the tackle for just a short gain.
Second and 6. Going on the ground with Homer. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. On third down, Wilson. This is caught. Touchdown, Seahawks. DK Metcalf, 26 yards. And the Seahawks are going to retake the lead. The extra point now coming from Myers. And that makes it 14-10.
Michael Dixon, the kicker for Seattle.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
Give him nine there on the first down completion. They'll come up now on second and a yard. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 62 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. He can just kind of sense the momentum turning here. It's first and 10. To throw, it's Garoppolo. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there. And there we saw completion.
And the result here, the same as the last play. Another tackle behind the line of scrimmage by the Seahawks defense. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's 3rd and 2. Inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Going to drop this off to his fullback. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18.
11. Hey, gun. Check, cross.
Here's Mostert. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
And they won't be able to run another play. Time has expired on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 9, 2nd and about a yard.
Hey,
Garoppolo now. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. Touchdown, 49ers. Jamichael Hasty, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the 49ers have retaken the lead. But plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here. And they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 17-14. Touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. To the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry.
Good strong run against the 3-4 set. And that 3-4, you've got to have your guys up front eat up a lot of blocks. The guy playing over the center, the nose, he usually has to take on double teams. But when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage. And that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. So that'll back him up five. So the delay of game penalty backs him up. It's now second and seven. A handoff to Penny. He'll have a first down past the 40 as he'll get this one up to the 44-yard line. 44 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. This is Homer. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That's 30 yards now in the last two plays. Back-to-back 15-yarders, and they're rolling. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. To throw is Wilson. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The first down screen pass, good for 5.
Boy, that was certainly well-read defensively. And the key to any screen play is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle him for just a short gain.
Here's 2nd and 5 now from the 37. A quick throw out to Lockett.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
They go back to the ground now with Penny. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of three. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Here's a give to Penny. And here he'll get it down to the seven.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Penny, and he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Rashad Penny. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Seahawks have taken the lead here in the fourth. Now Myers for the extra point. It's up and good to make it 21-17. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Set to get this drive underway. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
On second down, Mostert. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing now is Garoppolo. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. 21, 21. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. A play fake from Mostert. Now Garoppolo. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
First and 10, it's Mostert. That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set him back for second down. Some time right, and this one's incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark really start to finish.
It makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Garoppolo to throw. This is caught. It's Sanu. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25.
But they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down. Got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understanding where they are in the field?
Back to the running game with Mostert. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. To throw, Garoppolo. And this one, incomplete. Oh, he couldn't hang on to it in the end zone, and that's one that'll haunt you. And now it brings up third down. It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. To throw is Garoppolo. Able to haul it in is Kittle. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow.
So it's now a 3-point game here in the closing stages, as a field goal now can only tie it. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. Coming up on second and seven. Wilson. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ball game. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Wilson to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Nick Bosa able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before that final whistle, defense with one last exclamation mark there getting the sack to end it.
I love how you phrased it because we were waiting to see what would happen. Obviously, we thought something would happen downfield. Instead, it happens in the offensive backfield, and that's your ball game.
Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.
nobody help when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away.